Today I will discuss the concept of consideration. Consideration is one of the most essential elements for formation of contract. It means something in return of something. It is the price or a value paid for the contract. It must be lawful. It refers to both the parties in a contract. That is known as quid pro quo. This is a Latin term and that means something in return of something. So consideration means something in return of something. Something which is given and taken. The word consideration in contract law refers to something that has some value in the eye of law. In simple words, it is nothing but a price that the promisee agrees to pay to the promisor. Now, this is price. This price can be paid as a benefit to the promisor and or a loss or detriment. Detriment means damage or injury or harm to the promisee. Consideration is the benefit that each party gets or expects to get from the contractual deal. For example, in a contract for the sale of a house, house is a consideration for one party, while the price is the consideration for the other party. In simple, consideration is the price of which one party pays to buy the promise or act of the other. Literally, it means something that is given in return for something else. Consideration of legal value given in exchange for a promise. It is in the form of money or promise to do or not to do something. It is based on the concept of a bargain for exchange. Bargain means karar or sauda. This means that both parties are getting something that they have agreed to. Usually something of value for something of value. In short, the term consideration means something in return that is quid pro quo. Different jurists have defined consideration as Pollock has defined consideration as the price for which the promise of the other is brought and the promise thus given for value is enforceable. Blackstone has defined the recompense given by the party contracting to the other. In Curie versus Mesa, Justice Lush has defined the term consideration as follows. A valuable consideration in the sense of the law may consist either in some right, interest, profit or benefit occurring to the party or some forbearance or detriment. Detriment means A forgiving B's debts. So here A is suffering detriment or he has suffered detriment in exchange for the goods would amount to consideration. So here consideration may be some forbearance, detriment or loss or responsibility given, suffered or undertaking taken by the other. In simple terms, anything of value that is promised by one party to another can be viewed as consideration. Illustration. A agrees to sell his car to B for rupees 50,000. Here, B's promise to pay the sum of rupees 50,000 is the consideration for A's promise to sell the car. And A's promise to sell the car is the consideration for B's promise to pay for the car, that is rupees 50,000. So basically, consideration means value. Consideration in contract involves the passing of value between the contracting party. The definition which is given under Indian Contract Act is as follows. Section 2D of the Indian Contract Act defines consideration as when, at the desire of the promisor, the promisee or any other person has done or abstained from doing or does or abstains from doing or promises to do or abstains from doing something, such act or abstinence or promise is called a consideration for the promise. So here, has done or abstained from doing means, here consideration may be past, it may be present, or it may be future. Consideration may consist of either an act means which one is legally bound to perform. For example, A engages B as a typist in his office for rupees 3,000 per month. So the monthly wage is a consideration received by B, and the services of B constitute the consideration received by A. So an act, that is also known as consideration. Another one, an abstinence or a forbearance. For example, A promises to forbear from suing B. If forbear means not to do something or to restrict, if B agrees to pay the amount plus interest due to him. Here, forbearance of A means, forbearance means he will not file a suit. So forbearance of A is the consideration for B's promise to pay. A person had a daughter to marry. The illustration, next illustration, a person had a daughter to marry, and in order to raise funds for her marriage, he intended to sell a property. His son promised that if the father would forbear or if he would not sell the property, he would pay the father rupees 50,000. So the father accordingly forbore. The abstinence of the father is consideration for son's promise to pay. Another example for abstinence or forbearance, if your pet damaged neighbor's garden pots and plants, your neighbor is legally permitted to sue you for the damage, but instead agrees not to sue you if you pay him rupees 1,000. So this agreement provides adequate consideration for the contract, because each party is giving up something in exchange. You are giving up some of your money while your neighbor is giving up the right to sue you. So this is another example of abstinence or forbearance. The third, a written promise. Example, P agrees to sell his car to Q for rupees 50,000. Here, Q's promise to pay the sum or amount of rupees 50,000 is a consideration for P's promise to sell the car to Q. And P's consideration is to sell the car to Q in return of the promise by Q to pay the sum of rupees 50,000. So here, sometimes consideration is positive or it is negative. So abstinence, that is known as negative consideration. So consideration here is given for not doing an act or for not doing something. This is called negative consideration. Illustration, X is a debitor and Y is a creditor. Y has given a loan to X, rupees 1 lakh. X denied to return the loan to Y. So Y says to X, I will save you to recover my loan money. X says to Y, if you do not sue me or file a suit against me for next 6 months, then I will give you rupees 10,000 more in addition to rupees 1 lakh of loan. Y agreed and allowed 6 months extension period. So here X got 6 months extension. So X consideration is 6 months extension period, and Y got additional rupees 10,000. So Y's consideration is additional rupees 10,000 for not filing a suit. So here consideration is negative for not filing a suit. So here forbearance, detriment, loss or responsibility suffered or undertaken also amounts to consideration. So this is a negative form of consideration. Thank you.